What's up, everybody? Welcome back. So hope you're all having fun in the Great League. I'm certainly having an absolute blast. And in today's video, I'm going to be going over a set of battles featuring the double steel team in the Great League. Now, I've been trying a bunch of off-meta stuff, but I finally decided to try out a set of battles with a hardcore meta line consisting of Registeel on the lead with Galarian Stunfisk and then Azumarill in the back. Now, this isn't the most solid team composition because it's going to struggle against Mudboy leads and Fighter leads as well. But against most of what you're going to see in the meta, it actually performs pretty well because Registeel and Azumarill, they've been part of the hardcore meta squad of Great League for a very long time now. And then Galarian Stunfisk has been the latest entry to that hardcore meta squad. And it's just been so OP, right? It's been all over the place now. Everyone's using it just because it's just so good and has such a fantastic moveset as well. And also, we encountered a lot of lag in the set, as I'm sure a lot of you have been encountering probably over the last couple of days. It's been even worse, especially after that maintenance break they had, I guess, on Monday, which is kind of hilarious. But anyways, this team actually managed to overcome lag and still pull off some nice wins as well. Some really exciting battles in here, so let's just get straight into it. Okay, moving on to the first battle here. I'm going to be leading with Registeel, with Stunfisk and Azumarill in the back. So we have Registeel into Hypno. This is a pretty positive matchup for Registeel because those confusions are resisted because of the steel typing. And the only thing that I have to watch out for in this matchup is a Focus Blast. But it's going to take them forever to get there, right? So I'm just going to go straight for the Flash Cannon here. This is going to do some nice neutral damage to Hypno if it goes unshielded, as it does there. And they make a switch into their Galarian Stunfisk, and I'm going to go into Azumarill here. Azumarill has a pretty positive matchup against Stunfisk because both Hydro Pump and Bubble would hit for super effective damage because of that ground typing. And I'm not going to shield anything in this matchup. I'm just going to go straight for the Hydro Pump here. I'm not even going to bait because I either want to get their shield or do a massive amount of damage here. And another charge move coming through. This is probably going to be an Earthquake, which would do some heavy neutral damage to Azumarill. But it's fine. I'm still not going to shield it here. It's going to do quite a bit of damage actually. So I'm just going to go straight for the Hydro Pump here. This should either take out the Stunfisk or get their first shield. So let's see what they decide to do here. They do shield that up, which is absolutely fine. And at this point, I'm not going to shield the Azumarill. I'm just going to let it go. I'll take the shield advantage at this point. Yeah, I probably could have shielded my Azumarill and then tried to go for a switch advantage. But because both Stunfisk and Registeel can handle Hypno, I'm not too worried about it. So I'm just going to come in with my own Stunfisk here and then try and get to an Earthquake. So unfortunately, they're able to get to a charge bow first. I'm like, you know what? We have two shields. There's no way there's an Earthquake. They're going to bait for sure. But unfortunately, they go straight for the Earthquake. So this is absolutely terrible. Almost one-shot my Stunfisk. And I'm going to go straight for the Rock Slide here. Even though Rock Slide is double resisted, because they have only one, they have a shield, I'm really hoping that they give up a shield. Unfortunately, they don't. So I should have gone straight for the Earthquake, to be honest, because we had very minimal health. I might as well just should have gone for it there. So it's still a pretty tricky situation to be in, right? So I'm just going to shield this up. There's going to be an Earthquake. And I'm going to commit to the complete lock-on farm down here. Even though lock-on is resisted, we're going to come out of this matchup with a lot of loaded energy here. So, yeah, we come out of this matchup with so much energy. Let's see what they decide to bring in. So they're going to come in with Azumarill. Like I said, we have over 100 energy right now. I'm going to go straight for the Flash Cannon here. This is going to do some nice neutral damage to Azumarill because of the fairy water typing. And because we have loaded energy, I'm going to be able to get to the second Flash Cannon before another charge move comes through. This should either get the shield from Azumarill or put it pretty low. Let's see what they decide to do here. They do let that go through, which is absolutely fine. Again, it's still a pretty tricky situation. So I'm going to have to make sure I shield the Hydro Pump correctly. I'm going to shield this up because if it's Hydro Pump, it would take us out from this range. I hope they're not baiting with Ice Beam. Luckily, they go straight for the Hydro Pump. This is perfect. So at this point, they're going to make a switch into their Hypno, and I'm going to go straight for the Flash Cannon here. So this should definitely get the shield from Hypno because it would take it out from this range. And also, Hypno has a lot of loaded energy, right? Because it hasn't thrown a charge move yet. So I'm just going to try and sack the Stunfisk here, and we managed to time it perfectly. So charge move coming through, let's see what it is here. It's a Focus Blast. That is absolutely perfect. So that was a lot of energy wasted there. And at this point, I'm hoping they don't get to a punch. But I'm going to go straight for the Flash Cannon here, and this should definitely take out Hypno. They probably had Ice Punch or Thunder Punch as their second move. But anyways, now it's just a race to the charge move, right? I don't think the Zazu has energy because it just threw a Hydro Pump onto my Registeel before switching out. And luckily, we're able to get to a Flash Cannon, and that's going to pretty much take out the Azumarill there. So Registeel for the win. Again, Registeel is just so OP in being able to finish off games. But we'll have to see what happens in Season 3, however, because Flash Cannon is going to take... I think with the new move updates, Flash Cannon is going to take a little more energy to charge. And then Focus Blast has been nerfed as well. It's going to do lesser damage. So it's going to be interesting to see what happens to Registeel in the Great League. It's kind of unfortunate that it's been nerfed a bit, but, it's... I guess it balances it out a little bit more as well. But anyways, we have a defense form Deoxys. So this is not a great matchup for Registeel because those counters are doing super effective damage. But because defense form Deoxys counters doesn't have stab, and also on top of the fact that it obviously doesn't have a very high attack stat, it really doesn't do that much. And Registeel is going to be able to win the Zero Shield, right? So at this point, I'm just going to go, I don't mind losing switch advantage. Because they're gonna, if they want to win switch advantage, they have to burn at least one shield, and I'll take shield advantage. Gonna let the Thunderbolt go through. It's gonna do some nice neutral damage there, and I'm just gonna go straight for the next Flash Cannon here. They should either take out the defense Deoxys or get their first shield. Let's see what they decide to do here. They do shield that up, which is understandable because at this point they can probably completely counter farmers down and have a lot of loaded energy to throw at whatever's gonna come out next, and. Yeah, but I'm just going to come in with Stunfisk, right? Because everything, all the charge moves that Defense Deoxys has is going to be resisted by Stunfisk. Because Rock Slide will be double resisted because of the Steel Ground typing. Thunderbolt as well will also be double resisted because of the Ground typing. And then, of course, Psycho Boost will be resisted because of the Steel typing. But those counters are still doing super effective damage, right? So definitely going to add up. And I'm just going to commit to the complete Mudshot farm down here. So... We are taking quite a bit of damage from the counters, but it's absolutely fine because we are going to come out of this matchup with a lot of loaded energy. Another Rock Slide coming through, again, really doesn't do that much. And Stunfisk with loaded energy can be extremely dangerous. So they're going to come in with Azumarill here. So I think I'm going to go straight for the Rock Slide here. So even though Rock Slide, even though it hits for neutral, it doesn't really do that much. But it's going to do an okay amount of damage as it does there. So at this point, I'm going to just go straight for the Earthquake here. So I was really trying to get a shield on the first charge move. Unfortunately, they don't shield that up. So I'm hoping they let this go through as well because it would do quite a bit of damage to Azumarill as it does there. So that's great. I'm going to switch into my own Azumarill to avoid getting farmed down. And they're going to throw a charge move. I'm really hoping this isn't play rough because that would hit for neutral. Whereas Ice Beam and Hydro Pump would be resisted. Unfortunately, it's a play rough here. That's not great. And they make a switch into their Registeel. So this is still pretty tricky, right? Because they still have a full health Registeel with a shield and a decent amount of health on their Azumarill. So this is going to be tricky here. And a charge move coming through. So I'm just going to have to shield this up, unfortunately, because at this point, I have to save as much health on my Azumarill as possible. And I'm going to go straight for the Hydro Pump here. So I think landing the Hydro Pump in this matchup is the key, because that's definitely going to allow me to have a better chance in winning this match. And luckily, we land the Hydro Pump. That's great. So this is a decent situation to be in, but still not we're still not out of troubled waters yet. So another Flash Cannon coming through, absolutely going to shield this up. We still have Stunfisk as a potential sack option in the back, which I can use as a third shield. So again, at this point, I'm going to overfarm and then throw the Ice Beam here. This should either get the shield from Registeel or put it pretty low. It should definitely start pressuring shields here because, yeah, gets the shield, that is absolutely perfect. And at this point, I'm just going to try and sack the Stunfisk here. And we don't exactly catch the charge move, but they're going to have to throw, right? Because Lock-On is resisted. And if they would try to farm us down, I might have gotten to a charge move. So Flash Cannon coming through. It's going to take out the Stunfisk. It's absolutely fine. I'm going to come in with Azumarill here and then completely bubble this Registeel down. As crazy as it may sound, they might have gotten to a Flash Cannon there. But they were probably very close to one anyways. And I'm just going to go straight for the Hydro Pump here. I'm not sure if the Azumarill... is in Hydro Pump range at this point, but I know that it has very little health, and I'm hoping this Hydro Pump KOs after we have a little bit of lag right here. I'm hoping I don't face the third shield glitch, but we land the Hydro Pump and take the win there. So again, as you can see, Azumarill coming in super clutch there. So Registeel pretty much took care of things in the first game and Azumarill in the second game, and these two are just, it's just such an OP combination basically. So moving into the third battle here, we have... This is where we start facing all the lag issues. This is where the lag issues get like go to another level here, but it's fine. I'm not complaining. It's not just that you lose because of lag. There are games that we win because of lag as well. So it kind of balances out, but it's frustrating at the same time. So anyways, we're met with an Umbreon. This is a pretty positive matchup for Registeel because and they make a switch into their own Registeel here. This is absolutely perfect because we have the energy advantage. I'm going to go straight for the Focus Blast here. unfortunately, we lag a little bit and they're able to get to a charge move first. So we lost a lot of energy there. And I'm like, okay, this is probably going to be a focus blast, but unfortunately, it's a flash cannon because I had no idea how much energy they had. But I'm going to go straight for the focus blast here. This is either going to lose super effective damage to Registeel or get the shield. Let's see what happens here. They decide to let that go through, which is absolutely perfect. And at this point, I'm trying to get to the next flash cannon before another focus blast comes through. But they're able to get to a charge move first. I'm like, there's no way this can be focus blast, right? There's no way they got to the second focus blast before we got to a second flash cannon. Unfortunately, they get to it. So that's how much we lagged there. We lost so much energy there. So that's really unfortunate, but it happens. And flash cannon should take out the Registeel. They let that go through, which is absolutely fine. They're going to come in with Umbreon here, and they're going to have to throw the charge move, right? Because Snarl is doing very minimal damage. And this is probably going to be a foul play, which is definitely going to take out Registeel from this range. And it's absolutely fine because we have switch advantage. I can just come in with my Azumarill. And then Azumarill is a pretty positive matchup against Umbreon. They're going to make a switch into their Cresselia and going to come in with Stunfisk here. So again, I'm hoping they don't have Grass Knot, but it's unlikely because most Cresselias in Great League run with Grass Knot. And that's going to do neutral damage to Galarian Stunfisk because of the Steel Ground typing. Whereas both Moonblast and Future Sight would be resisted. And I'm going to go straight for the Earthquake here. Earthquake, because most people don't like to shield their Cresselia, might as well just go for it. It would do heavy neutral damage if the lag relents, that is. So I'm just trying to click the Earthquake here. Fortunately, we're able to get it off. I thought, you know, Stunfisk would have fainted by now, especially with the amount of lag that we had. So yeah, I mean, like expected, nobody shields their Cresselia. And Cresselia isn't as tanky in Great League as it is in Ultra League because it's much further away from its full stat potential. So Grass not coming through. Again, it's going to do neutral damage, but it's absolutely fine. I'm not going to shield this one. I'll probably shield the next one. And I'm going to go straight for the Rock Slide here because this Cresselia is now in Earthquake range. They might be inclined to shield this, which is exactly what I want them to do here. And they do shield that up, which is absolutely perfect. And at this point, I think I'm going to shield this up as well because Azumarill in the back doesn't really need shields to get rid of Umbreon. So might as well just shield this up. And at this point, they're making a switch into Umbreon. I'm trying to get to this Earthquake here. Unfortunately, they're able to get to a charge move. You know, I should have immediately switched into my Azumarill because I needed to save the energy on Stunfisk to throw out the Cresselia later, right? So this is not a great situation to be in because they still have a full health Umbreon with a shield and a Cresselia in the back. So I'm just going to go straight for the Hydro Pump here. This is going to do some heavy neutral damage to Umbreon. Again, most people don't like to shield their Umbreon as well because it's just so tanky. So might as well just go for the nuke move here. So yeah, it does about 40% of Umbreon's health. Charge move coming through. And it's going to be a foul play, which is going to be resisted. And it tells me they don't have last resort, right? I think in this matchup, and especially in the Umbreon Mirror and against Fighters, you definitely want to have that Community Day move of last resort. But because it doesn't seem as if they have last resort, I'm just going to commit to the complete bubble farm down here. As crazy as it may sound, yes, it's going to eventually put us into one Grass Knot range. But we're going to come out of this matchup with a lot of loaded energy, right? Another charge move coming through. Again, doesn't matter how many foul plays, we can easily take another 3 or 4 of them even. But yeah. We have like over 100 energy right now, but I'm fine with it. I'm just going to maintain that energy because I need to get off back-to-back charge moves onto the Cresselia, right? So yeah, another charge move coming through. Again, another foul play. This is definitely going to put us into Grass Knot range for Cresselia, but it's absolutely fine. And the game timer is starting to run out. Only 13 seconds left in the game. I need to get off these charge moves as quickly as possible here. So first Ice Beam. This should either get the shield from Cresselia or put it extremely low. And luckily, they let that go through, and they let that go through, and the timer runs out. So that was just, I mean, we had a little bit of luck there. I mean, obviously, we had a bit of lag, but they definitely should have shielded that, to be honest, because especially with the game timer running out, I mean, them shielding that would have meant that they had more health than Azumarill, and that would have taken the win. So this is a very weird matchup. So by the time I'm able to enter the matchup, we're already starting to take damage from the Stunfisk here. So at this point, I have no idea how much energy they have because they seem to have started the match even before I got into the battle. So another weird glitch there. And yeah, unfortunately, you know, we fall for the Rock Slide bait. And I'm just going to go straight for the Focus Blast here. So yeah, it's a really tricky situation to be in. And I don't even know if this is their first Pokemon or not because, like I said, we entered the battle like 2 or 3 seconds later. And we had a lot of lag here as well. And I'm going to switch into my Stunfisk to catch the Earthquake here. Now, this is going to do super effective damage, but I want to preserve the health of my Registeel. You know, I'm just going to sack the Stunfisk here. Unfortunately, you know, I can't come into Azumarill because that's my only counter to Stunfisk, and they have a Whiscash in the back. This is absolutely terrible. So I'm trying to get to a charge move here, but they're able to get to a charge move first. This is fine. It's going to take out Stunfisk, but at least now their Whiscash is switch locked into my Azumarill, right? That's actually pretty good because Azumarill is my only answer to Whiscash and other Mudboys in this team. So at this point, I'm just going to go straight for the Hydro Pump here. So no point baiting, and a charge move coming through from the Whiscash. And it ends up being a Blizzard, which is definitely not what you want to be going for because that's going to be resisted, whereas Mud Bomb would be neutral. And also, Blizzard is not very energy efficient on top of the fact that it doesn't have Stab. Definitely should have gone for Mud Bomb there. And I'm going to go straight for the Hydro Pump here. It does heavy neutral damage to Whiscash there, which is perfect. And at this point, I'm not going to shield anything. This is probably going to be a Mud Bomb. It's going to do very minimal damage anyways. And I'm going to come out of this matchup with a lot of loaded energy, right? So Mud Bomb coming through, it's absolutely fine. And we can just bubble this Whiscash down and have a lot of loaded energy. So let's see what they decide to bring back in here. So they're going to come in with Altaria, and then they switch into their Stunfisk to catch the Ice Beam. That was very smart play by them. But I'm going to build up to a Hydro Pump and then go for the Ice Beam here. Because we built up to a Hydro Pump, they might be inclined to shield this because Hydro Pump would take them out from this range and we get the shield. Absolutely perfect. At this point, we still have a shield. So I'm going to just shield up whatever they're going to throw right now. If it's a Rock Slide, we would survive it. But if it's an Earthquake, it would take us out. But I'm not going to take any chances here. I'm just going to shield this up. And perfect. Yes, they basically switch locked in this matchup right now, and I'm going to be able to get to this Hydro Pump. This is going to do super effective damage and pretty much one-shot the Stunfisk from this range. And now we're looking pretty good, right? We still have almost a full health Registeel in the back and a decent amount of health on Azumarill against an Altaria. This is pretty straightforward here. Those Dragon Breaths are double resisted. But I'm just going to switch into Registeel to catch the Sky Attack here because I assume that they would have gone to a Sky Attack before we got to an Ice Beam. So I thought, you know, I might as well just save that energy on Azumarill for later if needed. But at this point, this Altaria is just in double Flash Cannon range. So I don't think we'll even need Azumarill at this point. So it's going to go straight for the Flash Cannon here. This is going to do some heavy neutral damage to Altaria and put it into the yellow here. And of course, we lag a little bit. But yes, does put it into the yellow. And I think after these lock-ons, the Flash Cannon from this point, again, we face a little bit of lag right there. But I'm able to get to a Flash Cannon just in time here, and this should definitely finish off the Altaria. So, as you can see, we kind of started the game with a bit of a disadvantage in terms of, we started definitely with a significant energy disadvantage, but even then we were able to pull it off. So, as you can see, in two games in a row where in spite of lag, we were able to come through and pull it off. I guess the last game was maybe a little bit of luck involved with them not shielding the Ice Beam, but I think this game was like just a showcase of how strong this team can be, right? Even with a disadvantage of some form, you're going to be able to come back. So we're 4-0 in the set right now, and let's move into the final battle here. So we have Registeel into Skarmory. This is a very positive matchup for Registeel. Expecting a switch out here, and they make a switch into their Alolan Marowak, going to go straight into Azumarill here. So that probably was a mistake on their part. I mean, it's always a bit of a risk switching into your hard counter like that, especially because if people are leading Registeel, you're almost for sure going to have something like Azumarill in the back. And Shadow Ball does heavy neutral damage there. It's absolutely fine. I'm going to go straight for the Hydro Pump here because most people I observed don't shield and they expect the Ice Beam or play rough bait or something. But I'm just going to go straight for the Hydro Pump here. This is going to one-shot the Marowak if it goes unshielded, as it does there. And they're going to come in with Venusaur here. This is fine. This is still absolutely fine. I'm trying to get to this Ice Beam here, and we're able to get to this Ice Beam just in time. This is going to do super effective damage against Venusaur because of the grass typing, and either get the shield or, yeah, gets the shield. This is absolutely perfect, and they are farming us down for quite a bit of energy here, which is not great, but we still have Registeel in the back, right? Registeel is going to resist all of Venusaur's moves here, so just going to come in with Registeel and just soak up all the energy from this Venusaur. The reason I'm coming in with Registeel is because it's going to resist the Frenzy Plant, whereas Stunfisk could take neutral damage from it, right? And Stunfisk can also handle Skarmory, so I don't really need Registeel for it. Now the Frenzy Plant coming through, even though it's resisted, it still does quite a bit of damage, right? Because it's such a hard-hitting move. But they go for the Sludge Bomb. That's, again, definitely a mistake because Sludge Bomb is double resisted, whereas Frenzy Plant is single resisted. You definitely want to be going for Frenzy Plants. But I'm going to go straight for the Flash Cannon here. So I was actually thinking they might switch out on the charge move or something, but they shield that up, which is absolutely fine. And I'm still expecting a switch out. They're probably going to try and catch the Flash Cannon with Skarmory or something. But again, going to let this go through. Absolutely fine at this point. Frenzy Plant puts Registeel pretty low, but they're not switching out, so I'm just going to go straight to the Flash Cannon here. Flash Cannon is going to do heavy neutral damage to Venusaur and pretty much take it out from this range. And it's fairly a straightforward matchup from this point because we have a full health Galarian Stunfisk in the back with two shields against Skarmory, and there's nothing they can do. So they decide to give up the match, and that's going to be a GG. So that was a pretty straightforward win. I mean, probably the most easiest one of the five that we've played so far. But as you can see, it's a very solid team. Luckily, we didn't face any Mud Boys or Fighter Leads. But overall, that's a 5-0, and it's been a very solid team. And I did like a couple of sets of battles after this as well, and I went 4-1 twice. So overall, it's been a team that's been working really well for me as well. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up and also hit the subscribe button as well. I really appreciate all the support, and I'm going to try and bring out more interesting teams, and I'll see you guys next time.